Well, hello everybody. Welcome to your language teaching and learning channel. My name is Santiago, and this week we're going to be talking about action research. Now, the name at first may sound a little bit intimidating, but we need to realize the fact that we actually do action research all the time in our everyday lives. Okay, for example, when we take a shower, we sometimes just, you know, wash our bodies first and then shampoo our hair. And then one day we decide, okay, I wonder what happens if I do it the other way around. I wash my hair first and then I wash the rest of my body. And I realize that, first of all, it took me less time and maybe I feel cleaner longer. That's a possibility. Or when we go out, either shopping or go to work, and we decide to go to take a different route, and it turns out that it works out better. There's less traffic, and I get to work faster. Experimenting, that is action research in our regular daily lives. When it comes to teaching, the more appropriate name would be classroom research, okay? And in that case, the name sounds a little less intimidating. But sometimes teachers say, well, yeah, that's up to the experts to do it because of the research. What we don't realize is the fact that we have been doing it without realizing it, okay? Action research or classroom research is when we do an activity in class, and there are two things that can happen. When we try a new activity or we are teaching something new, there are two things that can happen. Either the activity is a success or it bombs, okay? In the case that the activity is a success, we have similar two things that can happen. We either leave it and keep it the way it is, or we improve on it, okay? Let me give you an example. I was teaching basic tense, simple present, and we were working on question words. So I had devised a few questions in order to have the students practice the question word structure and reinforce the simple present. So it was easy questions like, what time do you wake up? What's the first thing you do? What time do you have breakfast? And so on. So I did the activity, and by the end of the day, I had the same level of classes throughout the day, so different classes but the same level. So I tried the same activity in all of the classes, and what I noticed at the end of the day was that the activity worked. However, it seemed a little bit dull. Generally, we were getting the same answers. It's just that, you know, somebody woke up at 5, somebody woke up at 6, and it was okay. They were practicing and reinforcing. But again, it was a little bit dull. And of course, from the training and teaching experience, we know that students learn more, retain more of the language when they are doing an activity and having fun with it. So thinking about that, I decided to do the same activity again on the next day. However, I made a little change to it. I put the students in group and I said, okay, fine, and what you're going to do is you're going to think of crazy, extravagant answers to the questions. And the group with the craziest or the most extravagant answers is the winner. Okay, so I ended up having sentences like, after I take a shower, I run to my helicopter in order to go to work, or I go to my jet in order to go to France and buy some cheese in order to have for breakfast or something like that. I found that the students obviously had more fun with it, trying to be creative, and they actually enjoyed doing it and retained more of the language. Okay, so that's action research. Worst case scenario, as I mentioned, is the activity doesn't work. Okay, then we need, you know, two things that can happen. We say, okay, forget it, I'm never going to try that activity again. Or you can say, okay, why didn't it work? What was the problem? Okay, and this is one thing we need to remember. As I mentioned, when you mention this to teachers and they say, classroom research, that's up to you guys, the experts, to do it. Not really, we've done it in class. And you need to take into account one thing. Who is the expert in your classroom? You are, okay? No matter what the researchers tell you, no matter what they do, we always try to share information and we give you tips and suggestions, but it's up to you to adapt them to your classroom reality, because you're the only one, you're the expert there. You're the only one who knows your students, you know your classes, you know your environment, you know the cultural aspects of your classroom, right? So that's why you're the expert. So if you have an activity that bombs, either possibility one, forget it, never try it again, or possibility two, why didn't it work? How can I change it in order to make it work for my other students or in the future? Okay, and this is the basic idea of action research, which in the long run helps us to become better teachers. Okay, I'd like to share a little something that I got from the first course that I took on action research quite a while ago. It was taught by Dr. Andy Curtis from the University of Toronto. Okay, and this is what he had. Action research is act on the research, and action research, okay? Because it's a never-ending activity. No matter how long you've been teaching, no matter how many things you have tried, there will always be something new that comes up, okay? And as you know, the example that I gave you, you know, you may try an activity in the morning in your first class, and it doesn't work, and you improve it. Even if it works, you improve it for the next class, and by the end of the day, if you had the same levels throughout, you will find that the activity works the best way, and that is action research. Okay, we'll continue talking about this next week. Thank you very much for having joined me. Please don't forget to like the video, share it with your colleagues, and subscribe to the channel, and I look forward to your joining me next week. Thank you very much and take care.